Good evening. Opening ceremonies are still a little more than 3 days away, but here in Beijing, the competition to win the right to host the 2016 Summer Olympics is already underway. Tokyo hit first, taking advantage of a slow news day in the build-up to the beginning of the Olympics. Tokyo's bid team gave a few hundred reporters a snapshot of that city's plan for an environmentally friendly Olympics in the heart of the city. But will the IOC want to bring the games back to an Asian country so soon after Beijing?
I understand that they have no rotation policy.
Do you believe that?
Yes, of course.
Chicago's bid team is still arriving in Beijing. Instead of flashy photo ops, Mayor Daley is being counseled to take a more subtle approach, building one-on-one relationships with members of the International Olympic Committee.
Well, I've always felt like it's a lot about people and the people who are involved in your bid and the trust and confidence that they have. This is the franchise that the Olympic movement has given to you.
In China, the 2016 candidate cities are seeing a nation that spared no expense for the games. The government reportedly spent $40 billion on stadiums and infrastructure improvements.
We transformed from a fairly stagnant northern backwater city to a super city in just a short period of time.
On Monday, a rare but small protest erupted near Tiananmen Square, where residents displaced due to games construction made their anger known before being led away by police. The Chinese government says it only forced 15,000 residents to relocate to make way for Olympic venues. Human rights groups put the number much higher. If you look just behind walls plastered with images of welcoming Chinese, you'll see the remnants of several buildings bulldozed, in this case for Olympic family parking. Loyola Academy grad Ed Lehman moved to China 21 years ago and says hosting the games requires a certain selflessness, which the Chinese people have in abundance.
It's the idea of sacrifice for the greater good, which is to make China look fantastic during the Olympic period. And so, you know, I think Chicagoans are up for the challenge, Frank. I mean, we're the city that works.
We're now in what's called the international phase of the 2016 competition. When Mayor Daley arrives here tomorrow, he will immediately get to work trying to sell Chicago's plan to some of the thousands of international journalists here, not to mention meeting with members of the International Olympic Committee. Reporting from Tiananmen Square, Ben Bradley, ABC 7 News.